What is going on YouTube? It's your boy LilMikeMike6, and today you will see me playing with the Predator. And the Predator is really, really, really good in this game so far. I really like the Predator a lot. He kind of reminds me of this other character that I used to play with all the time in Mortal Kombat 9. You all know him, Cyrex. He kind of reminds me of Cyrex a lot. Because he can set traps, and then he can also do other moves to kind of like set you up and stuff. He kind of reminds me of Cyrex a lot. I don't know why. I don't know if you guys feel that way, but he kind of does. And he's really good though. He's a really good character. And that move right there, if it hits, then it actually pauses him for a few seconds so you can get a combo off. I don't know if you guys knew that or not, but he can kind of slow his opponents down with that move. The only bad thing about it is it disappears if you get hit, so that's the only bad thing. And I might actually make a how to use Predator video, and if I do make one with Predator, it might be a little long. It might be kind of like the Tanya one, but what I was thinking about doing, instead of doing it as long as the Tanya one, I might actually do 3 different variation videos. Because Predator and Tanya are so much different, like, that you can't just explain one variation. You almost have to explain all 3, because the variations are so much different from each other. It almost makes him a completely different character. Like, there's so much to talk about with the variation that I'm using now, where you can shoot the shoulder cannon at him. There's so much that you can learn doing that specific variation, and it takes a lot of time to kind of explain how to do it. It takes a lot of time to explain his warrior variation, which his war, okay, and then his hunter variation. So I'll explain how this pretty much works. In this specific variation, this is the variation that you can pretty much range people out with, is his I don't even know how to pronounce this, but I'll just say the variation with this shoulder cannon. So this is a variation you could pretty much range someone out with. You have the shoulder cannon, and then on top of that, you can kind of angle it. You can go up, down, straight, however you want to do it. And you can actually put that into combos. And if you guys seen my combo video, I actually use it to do a few combos. And then he has his hunter variation. So I believe that his, whatever the shoulder cannon variation is, I believe that one is a range variation. I think his hunter variation is a trap variation for setting traps and kind of trying to, like, look at this. I just kind of played around with this dude. He couldn't do anything. And I think you can actually hold it for, like, for pretty much the whole game. So if you find somebody and you want to just keep doing them with that, doing that to him and making him just sit there and wait it out like that, and you can do that, or they might even try to attack you. And I don't know if you can cancel out of that or not, but you can range people out with that, and it's pretty funny. And then his hunter variation is like I was saying, I think it's like a trap variation. So more than likely, it's mostly a setup variation. It's all about setups with that variation. When you pretty much apply pressure, and then towards the end of a combo, you want to, like, put out another setup to where you can continue your combos. Like, I noticed that little disc right there that I just threw out, like, whenever you finish a combo, it's really good to throw that out. Like, not even just do, like, an ending chain, like, to get that extra damage, just throw that little disc out at the end. And then after that, like, they can't wake up, and if they do wake up, then it'll more than likely hit them. And what I do is I just block for the first few seconds until I see it actually launch out, because then it won't stop. Once you get hit or anything, it won't actually stop, so it'll actually hit them. So I just go ahead and put in a button command to go ahead and try to attack the opponent, just in case, you know, like, they do try to attack me or something, and then the disc hits them, then I can get that extra damage, or I could just go for some chip damage. And then I actually, like, if I see they're blocking, then that's a good thing about Predator. You can hit confirm really a lot. So I just kind of hit confirm most of it, and if they're blocking, if I see that the first hit doesn't land, then I just go ahead and play it safe and do another, like, trap or something. I'll throw another trap out. Like, I'll throw, like, in the hunter variation, I'll throw out, like, a little snare trap. And what the snare trap basically does is it just kind of puts a little ring around you, and then it's like a, it's almost like a snare trap. And if you guys have ever seen the Predator movie, it's like a snare trap that was in a movie where if you walk past it and it steps on and you step on it, or if you get in the vicinity of it, then it'll snatch you in the air like by a tree branch or something. Like, I don't know how to explain a snare. You guys should probably know what a snare trap is anyways, but it basically just kind of pulls them in the air, and then they'll sit there for a few seconds, and then it'll give you time to kind of attack them. And that's what I use the hunter variation for. And I actually use it in a different kind of way. I actually use it as if it's not even meant for that. Like, I actually implement it into my combos. If you meter burn it, then the lights will come on immediately, so you can actually just knock them right into it and then just throw the snare trap down, and it'll catch him like soon as it hits the ground. So that's how I kind of use it to pull off some combos. And I'm sure you guys have seen my combo video. If you haven't, go ahead and go check that out. But you'll see me do that in some of the combo videos. I like the snare trap. It's pretty cool way to attack with Predator and the hunter variation and get off a lot of damage. And then lastly is his warrior variation. Now, his warrior variation is, I think, his offensive variation, the one that you use to play really aggressive with Predator. And he does have some setups in there too. Like, each variation Predator has like a setup move. Like, he has a setup move that goes for all of his variation, which is the disc that you throw out. That's his move that pretty much is universal. But then he has a snare for his hunter, and then for his warrior, I believe it's his explosion, which I don't even think that's really like a setup. It's just more of something to kind of get you a stronger combo in, like more strong comboing or whatever you want to call it. But his warrior variation is more aggressive and offensive. He has more hand-to-hand attacks, so he has like a hair hit where he can hit his hair at you or something. Like, he can flip his hair up. I don't know the name of it, but it's called like his hair flip or something. And you can actually knock him into the air with that move, and then you can continue a combo, or you can do a move where he kind of jumps at you and then he can pop you in the air. And it has like different ranges where you can actually choose what range. And look at this nasty brutality right here. Predator, I mean, his brutalities are so easy. I was pulling them off pretty much about 85% of the matches that I played with Predator. I was pulling them off, and so far I haven't lost. I've actually played possibly 30 matches with Predator, and I haven't lost with Predator yet. So he's one of my best characters already. And like I was saying earlier, I don't know if I mentioned this already or not, but Scorpion is still my main character. He's still my main player right now. I think Scorpion is my best, and the only reason I think Scorpion is just still my best is simply because I had a lot more time to practice with Scorpion, and I don't really drop Scorpion's combos as much as I drop Predator so far. But that's just because Predator is a new character for me, and also I don't know how to do Harley resets just yet with Predator. But I can tell you this, more than likely I will be doing some resets with Predator, because it does look like he has some really easy resets, and they're probably going to be some setup resets that you can pull off, where you can actually attack and then throw a disc out or something. But they'll be kind of, I don't want to say they'll be like, I don't know, it'll possibly be like something where I don't even know if they're even considered a reset at that point, but it'll be like traps resets, kind of. It's kind of like once they wake up, then you can pretty much trap them. And when I make his how-to video, when I finally make Predator's how-to video, I'll show you guys some really nice stuff with his hunter variation that you can do. And I kind of like his hunter variation because it has some really sick moves, like, that you can pull off, and some really sick trap moves that you can use. And you can actually stop people from really doing anything to you after you finish a combo with that specific variation. Like, they have to just block the entire time. And I'll show you guys a couple of those moves. That's why I like his hunter variation so much. Now, you might have to use a bar meter to pretty much do some of this stuff, and it's pretty cool. But in his hunter variation, I'll explain some of it anyways, just in case I do forget. With his hunter variation, like, say for instance, if you're using the hunter variation and you throw down a snare trap. Well, if you throw down a snare trap after you've done something that's like positive on block, to where it's like a few seconds delay or whatever, and then you're able to block after you've thrown down the one of the snare traps, and you can throw it and change the range. If you throw it and put it right in front of yourself, like really close, if that character that you're playing against can't teleport and get on the other side of you to avoid the snare trap as a whole, all you have to do with Predator is block. And if you block and they try to attack you, then the snare trap will catch them because it's the closest one to you. It'll catch them, and then it'll put them in the air, and then you get you a free combo. So it's almost like whenever you're playing with Predator, people can't really do anything to you if you know how to use them. And so far, I haven't, like, I've done it already once to somebody, and you guys will probably see it when I use the hunter variation. I did it to him. A guy tried to attack me and I was blocking, and the attacking that he did, it pushed him back into one of the snare traps. And sometimes I'll actually just throw a normal range and let somebody attack me and just block, and the pushback from him hitting me actually pushed him back into the snare, and it caught him, and then, you know, it kind of pulled him into the air. So that's pretty funny. And then also, Predator has, I don't even want to even explain it, but I'll explain it anyways. But his back 2-2 is possibly one of the farthest range moves in the entire game. And if you guys don't know what that is, that's his triangle. Like, if you hold back and press triangle, or hold back and press YY on Xbox, that's possibly one of the farthest ranging moves in the entire game. You can almost go full screen just by doing that, and then doing his that move where he stabs you in the stomach. You can pretty much almost go full range with Predator doing that. So far he's a really good character. He's really good. The only flaw he has is what I think is his range, and the variation that I've been using so far, well, not even, because I've used all three, and I think that playing with all three feels like a completely different character each time. So it almost feels like I have to really learn each variation to learn the full character, because I kind of feel like I haven't learned Predator when I don't use each variation. So, but that one variation where he has a shoulder cannon on, that's the only variation he really has really any range. So if you're playing against a good Kenshi should be able to range Predator out. But this guy really, I don't think he really knew what he was doing too much. And then, if you pick Jackie Briggs, I think Jackie Briggs could shut Predator down, which I really thought that they should have put the shoulder fire cannon in all of Predator's variations. And then for whatever that variation where he actually has a shoulder cannon, just put something else in that specific variation. They could have possibly put like a net in that variation where he throws out a net like Cyrex or something. I don't know. But one where he just actually throws a net out at you or something. I don't know. Anything really. It could have been his hunter, you know. Well, I guess his hunter variation is already in here, but they could even put I'm trying to think. They could even put like a teleport in there or something, or they could have put a teleport in there for Predator in that variation. They could have made it to where like he jumps up in the air and like hides in the trees or something, and then just comes down and attacks you like Goro or something. And it could have been an attack like that, you know. It would have been pretty cool. Or they could have made it kind of like Batgirl from Injustice, like the exact same kind of move where he just kind of like teleports and then comes down and grabs you, and it holds you in the air for a few seconds on some kind of tie, and then he's able to attack you. That would have been pretty cool for Predator. But look at this brutality. Just doing him nasty. Doing him completely nasty. But I kind of thought that his shoulder cannon should have just been for every variation because he's kind of weak at that point. But I don't know. Only time can tell. Right now, it looks like Predator's probably going to get some nerfs anyways. So some people will probably be pretty heated for me even saying that anyways, because I've already seen people complaining about Predator saying that he needs to be nerfed and all kind of stuff. Me, I don't think he needs to be nerfed because he doesn't really have any range. So once people figure that out, then he might still get nerfed, but it's no telling. I mean, he does do a lot of damage. I can honestly admit that. I mean, I've already pulled off a 55 with Predator so far, and they were already nerfing some characters for damage scaling, for doing like 40% combos. So if they were nerfing characters for 40% combos, who were doing like 40%, and they were pretty much maxing out at that, some of them were maxing out like kind of late 40s, early 50s, or whatever. But they were nerfing some of those characters like crazily. So more than likely, Predator pulls off some easy 50s, like easy 50s. His hardest one wasn't even his 55. It was one of his 40% combos that I did. But his 50s are really, really, really easy. So more than likely, they'll probably nerf Predator. They'll probably change up. I mean, if I had to say, they probably will make that one attack where he attacks you in the stomach, they'll probably make that a lot weaker. More than likely, they will. Probably make it do hardly any damage. They might even slow it down, take some armor off of it. No telling. Because I've seen a lot of people complaining that they can't beat Predator, and so far I haven't been beat with Predator. So because I've been playing with him, that could be the reason why I don't see him as OP. But only time will tell. Only time will tell. Also, I think I've already mentioned this, but like I said, right now I think Predator is my favorite to play with. And like I say, Scorpion's still my main though. Scorpion's probably still going to be my best character for a while. And then Predator will probably be the character that I go to for fun. Just because I like... Look at this. So, check this out. Watch this. Even if you lose to Predator and he doesn't fatality or brutality, look, he still kills you no matter what. So, he still fatalities you because he snatches your skull out. So, the default move, even if you don't do a fatality, he still kills you. So funny. So you really don't even have to do a fatality with Predator because he's going to fatality him no matter what. You're going to die if you face Predator if he wins. So, but like I said, Predator is real cool. He's a real cool character. It's going to take a lot of time to really learn all three of his variations. And look at that. That's the move I was talking about right there. That's his back 2-2. Which it has so much range on it. It's like a move where he hits you with his stick, and it has so much range on it. I actually like this warrior variation, but one of his moves kind of frustrates me. This move right here, check this out. Like, if you run in and you get hit, look at this. And I don't know, I actually lost some damage and didn't even hit him with the explosion. But if you activate that and then you get hit, the bomb stops, and I don't really like that. I think that it should. Look at this, see? And so the explosion actually stops, so it doesn't activate, and you'll see me run in, and look at this. This is how it's supposed to activate right there, and then you see me pull off the little combo right there. I like that move. I like doing that like that. But sometimes it doesn't activate, like if you get hit or something like that. I think it's just still activate, to be honest. But I guess it's for balancing purposes, because it'll probably be pretty OP because people already have a tough time getting in on Predator just because he has so much like offense. And look at this. That's so funny of a brutality. You just kind of activate that explosion and just run up and just detonate right on him. It's so funny. The guy was all pissed off. He was like, hey, what happened? He didn't even know he was that low on health, which is so funny. But like I say, Predator has so much offense that I mean, he really doesn't even have much range. Even in his range variation, he really doesn't have much range. He still can be beat out from the outside. Like he I don't know. He doesn't have a lot of range except for his like physical attacks, which kind of he does have some moves that moves you forward a lot. Like his back 2-2 clears a lot of the screen. Like it clears a lot of the screen, and even when you do that, like even if you miss with the attacks, then you can pretty much tell that you missed, and you have enough time to actually do his the like stomach lunge with the whatever that sword thing that he has on his arms, whatever that is, the blades. You can attack him with the blades, go straight for the stomach, do that little special move that he has. That has a lot of range too. So you can almost go full screen with Predator with just one chain of move. There it is, right there. That's the back 2-2. There it is again, and look at that. That's what I was talking about earlier with the snare trap. That guy couldn't do anything. He had to just sit there and block. Look at that. You could just pretty much bump them back. Like you, even if they're blocking, they're still going to hit it. They have to block high to avoid hitting it, hitting the snare trap. I mean, sorry, not block high, block low. They have to block low to avoid getting caught by the snare trap. But check this out, though. Here's the cool thing about Predator. If you press, I believe it's X triangle, or some people who like to know the numbers, the 3-2. If you press 3-2. If you press 3-2, there's an overhead attack in there, and it pushes you back a decent amount too. So all you really have to do is press 3-2. If you throw a snare trap down, just a normal one, that goes the normal range. If they're in front of that snare trap and you press 3-2, it's an overhead in that. So the last hit will actually push them back if they block that high. And if once it pushes them back, the snare trap will actually catch him. See, there it is right there. So the snare trap will actually catch him. It's so funny. And I caught this guy so many times, and he was getting pissed off. I've actually caught a lot of people with that move. So you can actually press 3-2, and it'll kind of push him back a little bit if they're standing blocking, and it'll hit them with the low attack, so they have to block high and then low immediately after. And if they're not blocking, then it'll still, like if they're blocking low already, then the overhead will catch them, and then they'll still fall into it, and then the snare trap will catch them, and then it'll be considered a combo. So that's something pretty cool about Predator. Look at that blocking skills right there. Look at that blocking skills. He went for the low and then the overhead, and your boy blocked both of them and then punished them forward. And look at this. Predator's so beast in the corner. Check this out. But he got out of the corner right there. But I've also figured out a way to just kind of punish someone in the corner. I figured out a way with Predator to just keep somebody in the corner and keep them from really doing anything. A lot of his moves almost feel like they're positive on block. I haven't really checked them all out, but every time I attack somebody, it feels like they really I get to attack again, because they can't really do anything with Predator unless I just stop attacking and allow them to do something. And look at this, I lost right here because I didn't want to attack. I was actually trying to do his brutality, and I think I'll actually do it in this match. I can't remember, but I think I was actually going for brutality, so I allowed him to win so I can try to do the brutality. And look, he tried to do what the very first guy did, which was kind of spam those moves. Look at that. And your boy actually gets beat out of the snare trap move right there. And so I kind of kick him back a little bit. Look at this. I throw down a snare trap. That's exactly what I was talking about right there. So he can't really get out of that, which I thought was so funny. He can't really get out of it at all. And I think you guys will love this brutality that I pull off at the end of this match. It's so sick. And it's possibly one of the coolest brutalities in the game. And the way that I do the brutality is even more sick, because he doesn't expect it. Check this out. Oh my god, I love it. I want to thank you guys for watching, checking out my video. Peace.